I will honor the results of the election, and I'm hoping that my opponent would do the same.
I have always accepted election results that are fair and that are following the Constitution. At this point, it would be similar to saying that before a surgery takes place to find out whether or not, to decide whether or not the surgery went well.
11 News lead political reporter Kate Amar was there when the two rivals took the stage and joins us now with more of the big highlights.
This gubernatorial debate offered Maryland voters their first chance for a side-by-side comparison of the top two candidates and their positions on key election issues.
This can be Maryland's moment.
I intend to put power back in the people's hands.
Republican nominee Dan Cox and Democratic nominee Wes Moore delivered their opening remarks in the gubernatorial debate, and then they took their gloves off, each candidate working to define the other for Maryland voters.
You cannot trust what comes out of my opponent's mouth.
Frankly, I'm standing on stage right now with an extremist election denier whose rhetoric and whose policies are not just dangerous and divisive, but will take our state backwards.
Topics included abortion, the election, and public safety, and exchanges were heated at times.
He wants to defund the police, and not just that, he wants to indict the system. Now, that's not talk and rhetoric that's safe for any one of us.
My opponent likes to say that he backs the blue. The irony is the blue doesn't back you because the police officers have endorsed our campaign.
Both candidates called each other extreme and dangerous, accused each other of mischaracterization, and worked to appeal to women voters and to supporters of Governor Larry Hogan.
What Governor Hogan said about being unfit to be in this office, you are putting on full display right now.
I have had lunch with the governor. I have toured the State House, so I'm not sure where you've been.
So who won the debate? That's a question we put to the debaters.
I think voters have a very clear understanding of not just who I am, but also the danger that my opponent presents.
I think we did very well. I'm not going to say that it's something to win or lose. I think it's getting the message out. That's what I came for, and that's what I did.
Delegate Cox said, "Let's do this again," and he called for another debate ahead of Election Day. However, at this point, it appears this will be the only head-to-head matchup of these two candidates. In Owings Mills, I'm Kate Amara, WBAL TV 11 News.
Okay, thank you. You can watch the full debate on our website or right on your phone with our mobile news app. Just head to your phone's app store and search for WBAL-TV 11 News and make sure to turn on push alerts for all your Commitment 2022 updates.